I've learned to appreciate a lot of the native plants just recently, because I've noticed the beauty in them and their usefulness within our daily lives. I get excited when I see an intact native forest and how it should look. If we're not able to monitor these invasive species and control them, then we may lose all of our resources. A lot of people, they don't understand that those plants don't belong there. So that's why it's important, I believe it's important for us to monitor and manage these invasive plants.
For millions of years, the Pacific Ocean served as a tremendous barrier to limit the arrival of new plant and animal species to our islands. Over time, the few organisms that did arrive evolved into a vast collection of unique organisms found nowhere else on Earth. With the arrival of people on canoes, ships, and airplanes, the rate of species introductions greatly increased. Some of these species that have been introduced are quite damaging to Hawaii's natural environment. It's estimated that 850 plant species are non-native here, in other words, have been introduced by humans, versus the 1,100 species that arrived and evolved here naturally.
In the most extreme cases, ecologically disruptive species like Miconia in Hawaii, Albizia in Hawaii and American Samoa, and Eikoa in Hawaii, American Samoa, and on Guam completely displace native plants. The 11 national parks in Hawaii, Guam, Saipan, and American Samoa protect much of the most healthy and least invaded ecosystems remaining on their islands. The Pacific Island Network Inventory and Monitoring Program of the National Park Service is responsible for providing park managers scientific data to track invasive species in these protected areas. Preventing the introduction of invasive plants to Pacific Islands is the most cost-effective defense. The National Park Service is conducting surveys within parks of roads, trails, fence lines, and parking lots, in order to locate new plant invaders before they become a serious problem. Surveying these corridors is critical because they often serve as primary pathways for species introductions by both people and animals. Surveys consist of walking along roads, trails, or fences and recording all target invasive plant species and new potential invaders. Suspect plant sightings are identified and reported immediately to park resource managers.
It's easier to manage 10 young fire trees next to the road than it is to get at a huge forest like this that has become established and overgrown.
What we have here is a Himalayan raspberry. It might not look like much, but this is an invasive species that can grow large and threaten the Hawaiian ecosystems. When we monitor plants and catch them at this stage, it'll be easier for us to manage them later.
But invasive species do not respect park boundaries. To effectively limit invasions on an island-wide scale, it is crucial to partner with people and organizations outside of the parks to encourage communication across islands by contributing to a data management and reporting system. By sharing information, the National Park Service supports the effective control of invasive plants, not only within its borders, but spanning the fragile and unique islands on which we live. Long-term monitoring of invasive plant species already established within native park ecosystems is also essential for successful management. Monitoring provides important information about the abundance and distribution of invasive species, allowing park managers to assess current and changing threats, formulate appropriate control strategies, and prioritize areas and species for management. Long-term monitoring also allows managers to evaluate the effectiveness of previous management actions, such as the removal of mammals, which are known to spread invasive plant seeds. A team of National Park Service biologists collects data on invasive plant species along sampling transects, or path-like lines.
We have statistically determined the best locations to conduct our transects so that we can deliver the most accurate information to park managers regarding invasive species abundance, distribution, and then the trends over time.
The reason why we run transects is because we can't count every plant in the forest. So we pick specific areas, and in those areas we lay down transects.
We have our start location and we're going in one specific direction for a kilometer. And so we'll look every 20 meters, we'll stop and record all of the weeds we see within that distance, 0 to 20 meters, 20 to 40. And then, so basically along this line, we'll look for the weeds, and then make an estimate of how much that weed consists of the whole 20-meter distance. And then every 200 meters we stop and we take a GPS point, and on our permanent transects do photographs and put in a post so that every 5 years people can come back and do the same measurements we're doing, and therefore you can see how the forest has changed, how much the weeds have increased or decreased.
Data gathered using this monitoring method is coupled with data on new or potentially destructive invasive species to provide managers with a comprehensive picture of a park's invasive plants threat. Invasive species on islands are a fact of life. They can have devastating effects on native plants and animals, as well as on culture and the economy. We cannot undo these introductions. But by working together through control efforts and the sharing of information, and staying vigilant through education and science, we can keep invasive species at bay and continue to protect our treasured native island ecosystems.